Hardness is the resistance a mineral has to being scratched. It is a measure of the bond strength that is found in the mineral. Mohs scale of hardness identifies 10 minerals of increasing hardness that are useful in testing other minerals for hardness. They include 1. Talc, 2. Gypsum, 3. Calcite, 4. Fluorite, 5. Fluorapatite, 6. Orthoclase, 7. Quartz, 8. Topaz, 9. Corundum, and 10 is diamond. In addition to that, there are other common materials useful for hardness testing. They are, a fingernail has a hardness of about 2.5, copper comes in at 3, glass is 5.5, and the steel of a file is 6.5. In addition to that, we have some hardness points here. This one has a piece of plastic, and its hardness is about 2. On this end is copper, hardness of 3, and then the next 3 sets of pens have different types of metal alloys for hardnesses from 4 all the way up to 9. No diamond point. The hardness point here with a 9 scratches everything except diamond. In doing a hardness test, it is often very useful to start off with glass. Glass at a hardness of 5.5 is kind of in the middle of the hardness scale. So testing an unknown mineral on it kind of divides it in two parts. So the process of taking the hardness of a mineral is, first of all, find a mineral that has a nice sharp point, clean without any kind of corrosion on it, and then rub it on the glass plate. And it only takes maybe a pound of pressure or so to rub it lightly across the surface of the glass plate. Sometimes you can hear it scratch, and if it does scratch the glass plate, often you can feel it sort of digging in. So I can see a couple of scratches on there right now where I had this crystal rubbed across the glass plate. Here's another interesting mineral that was cut into a sphere. As I rotate it around, you might get an idea of what this is based on another physical property called cleavage. There are incipient cleavage planes in this mineral. Here and here are a couple good examples. Now, I got this one really cheap because across the bottom, it was cleaved. Right? That flat surface is a cleavage face, but that makes it an ideal spot to test for the hardness. So let's start off with glass. Here's the glass plate, and I'll rub it across this mineral. Definitely left a scratch on the surface of it. So the hardness of this mineral is less than 5.5. So we'll use the hardness points. Let's go down to number 4, see if it scratches it. Definitely left a scratch right there. This mineral has a hardness of less than 4. Let's go down to hardness of 3. Here's the copper again. Doesn't seem to be scratching it. In fact, I see a little bit of copper rubbing off on the surface of it. Let's try the hardness of 2. Nothing. I feel it sliding. My fingernail? No. So the hardness of this mineral is greater than 2.5, maybe 3, and less than a 4. Well, the mineral, based on the property of cleavage that you can see in the specimen, this is a piece of calcite that has been sculpted into this spherical shape, right? A nice cleavage face across the bottom there. This metallic mineral is either pyrite or chalcopyrite. Hardness of pyrite is 6.5. It should scratch a piece of glass. Hardness of chalcopyrite is only 3 and will not scratch glass. So that seems like a pretty easy test to perform in this specimen. So I got the piece of glass here, and again, with just fairly light pressure, and I'm looking for a nice point here on this chunk of rock, and rub it across here, and it definitely scratched the glass. So that is a positive test for pyrite. This is the mineral fluorite. What we have here is what's called a cleavage octahedron. It has 8 sides. Each side is a equilateral triangle, and there are 8 of them. So this specimen has 4 directions of cleavage. I took the time to polish one of the faces here so I could test it more easily for hardness. So this is the face here, and I'll take the piece of glass, rub it across the surface and see if it scratches it. Well, as you can see, it left a nice white line. That is definitely a scratch. Just to make sure, sometimes you want to reverse the process. So here's the glass plate. We'll take this point here, rub it across there, and I can feel it just sliding across the glass plate. So fluorite is definitely softer than 5.5. This is a sheet of biotite mudka. This is a nice thin cleavage fragment. What I'm going to do here is test the hardness of it as well. Now, the mica has a nice flat surface here, so let's test it with the glass. In this case right here, I'll take the piece of glass and rub it across the surface here, see if it scratches it. Definitely leaving a scratch. I can hear it, I can feel it digging in, and that's the scratch right there. Right, nice groove. Now, let's see what else we can use to scratch it with. Hardness points here. Here is the number 3 hardness point, copper wire. And we'll rub that across there. I can definitely feel it scratching, leaving a mark as well. In fact, let's try the fingernail. Try another spot right here. And it leaves that scratch. So this mica, biotite mica, has a hardness of less than 2.5. This is a crystal of the mineral kyanite. Some minerals have different hardnesses in different directions, and kyanite is one that shows that unique physical property pretty well. In fact, the hardness of the crystal in this direction is about 4.5, and the hardness in this direction is about 7. So I've got a hardness point here. This is the number 6. And in this direction right here, I'll try to scratch it. This slides across the surface there, not leaving a scratch. So I'll try to scratch it in the long direction. Can hear it digging in. Makes a nice white line that doesn't rub off. That is definitely a scratch on the surface of that crystal. So kyanite has a hardness that is lower in one direction than in the other direction. This is a piece of feldspar, plagioclase feldspar, called labradorite. In particular, this one is a semi-precious gemstone called moonstone because of the interesting iridescence or play of colors that it has in there. This is a polished surface. Now, the hardness of plagioclase feldspar is 6. That means that it is harder than a piece of glass. So I'll rub this piece of glass across the surface here of this polished surface, see if I can't scratch it. All right, a little bit of the glass comes off, but it definitely did not scratch the plagioclase, the labradorite. So we reverse this and see if it scratches the glass. Find a nice sharp edge there. Rub it across, just a little bit of pressure. Definitely leaves a scratch. So the mineral, plagioclase, is harder than glass. Now, let's try quartz on here. Here's a quartz crystal with a nice point. And we'll draw that across the plagioclase. Pick a side over here. And I can feel it digging in. And definitely leaves a scratch on the surface. So based on the test here of glass and quartz, plagioclase feldspar is between the two. And it comes in with a hardness of 6.